So my name is Kayla Viets, and we're in a fly research lab at Johns Hopkins. I'm working on this specific gene in flies that's called spineless. Our research has applications to a lot of different fields that are affected by how genes are turned on and off. So specifically, ours are really applicable to problems with color vision, various disorders where you can't smell properly, as well as autism and some immunodeficiencies. I'll do a lot of dissections of fly retinas, both when they're adults and when they're larvae and when they're pupae. And after that, I'll look at them under a fluorescent microscope that we have to see exactly where this gene that we're looking at called spineless is in the cell. I'm from Kansas City. I do have an uncle who's got a PhD in biology, and he actually studies geckos. But he was always very encouraging of my interest in science, and he sent me fossils when I was little. And as I got older, he gave me some advice about grad schools, about how to study biology. And now sometimes when I have like a grant proposal or something that I'm writing, I still send it to him to look over because I get that opinion of another scientist. But in high school, when I was taking AP biology, we started learning about how DNA goes from a gene to RNA and then to proteins. And I just thought that was the coolest thing ever. I don't know why, but that just really stuck with me. I thought it was fascinating that that's how life works. And I really just wanted to know more about that puzzle and finding things out about it that we don't already know. I'm able to decide, you know, what projects I want to do, what experiments I want to do every single day. And the other cool thing about that is it's stuff that no one's ever done before. I'm finding out about, you know, parts of biology that no one knows. And so that's what I really love, is making new discoveries. I'm making these probes for looking at the genes we're studying. I was trying to make probes in a new way that I hadn't done before. And I was very worried because, oh, you know, maybe it won't work. And then I tried very hard on this new experiment, and it worked perfectly on the first try. And that was really exciting. It was a great day. I called my mom and told her about it. Yeah, so that was really great.
You got a lot of positives. I'm really jealous.
Really?
I've been having so much trouble with it.
Yeah. Science is very difficult. You have to really persevere, because a lot of times your experiments aren't going to work out the correct way your first time. But the cool thing is that if you keep working at it, you really will make new discoveries. And that's what keeps me motivated, is even on the days when things aren't working out as well, I know that if I keep at it, it's going to be great. So yeah, I would say if you're interested in it, do it, even if it's hard.